Breaking new details about the murder weapon used to gun down a Bay Area police officer. Right now, as we come on the air, communities are coming together over the murders of on-duty officers. Good evening, everyone. I'm Jamison Euler.
And I'm Linda Hurtado. Wendy has a night off. A memorial for Tarpon Springs Officer Charles Kondik is now growing tonight as we're uncovering brand new details about this tragic shooting.
Our Edward Lawrence joins us live outside the police department.
And we are just learning that that gun, the 40 caliber gun, was stolen, that gun that was used to murder this officer. This is flowers are being added to this memorial. You can see flowers, balloons, and other keepsakes here, all for Officer Charlie K.
Messages of love and support sit on a police car in front of the Tarpon Springs Police Department. After nightfall, a steady stream of people came by to show their respects to Charlie Kondik. Some, like Emma and Dakota Freed, never met the officer, but still have a connection.
I didn't think I was going to get that upset and emotional because I don't know him and his family, but it's sad. It's very sad.
Mommy.
You know, we live here and it's way too close to home.
The murder of Charlie K., as people called him, hits close to Freed's home because she's married to a Pinellas County deputy who works in the jail. Freed sees this murder and the ambush of two officers in New York City as a very scary trend.
It is concerning. Like, it's been something we've been talking about.
There's even more for Freed to discuss after hearing the Glock 40 used to kill the officer was stolen last August in a burglary in Jacksonville. This afternoon, Charlie K.'s daughter thanked everyone for the support. She says her family appreciates the outpouring and says she wishes she had more time with her dad.
We're just going to take it day by day right now.
The entire city of Tarpon Springs is taking it day by day while honoring their fallen hero.
And there are two ways to donate to the family of Officer Charlie K. Both of those ways are on our website, abcactionnews.com. Reporting live from Tarpon Springs, Edward Lawrence, ABC Action News.